What's up, guys? It's Carson back here on Toxic Gaming, and today, guys, today we are here with our PIC battle against Potato Jim. I'm just gonna call him Jim. I'm not gonna say Potato all the damn time. And the Meath Mamoswines, that's his team, and we're actually bringing Mamoswine against him. If you did miss the team prep, preview, whatever you want to say that happened on Tuesday, go ahead and check that back before you watch this video, just so you know why I have the team I do. And we're about to get on into it. The team I'm guessing he's going to bring is going to be Mew, Mega Gyarados. I'm betting he's going to bring his Mega. He hasn't brought Mew yet, so I'm betting he's going to bring it this round. Volcarona, Cofagrius, Tyrantrum, and Malamar. And I'm assuming some type of Trick Room team. So that's why I kind of brought some of my slower Pokemon just to be able to kind of work in that a little bit. But I'm assuming some type of Trick Room team because he has a really good draft for Trick Room. If he brings Meloetta, if he brings Breloom, brings Nidoking or Florges, it's going to be a little weird, but I'm assuming more of a Trick Room team. So let's just get the challenge on going. I'm pretty sure he said it was ready and everything, so we're going to see how this goes. I did look at Skype to see his message, but we're just going to challenge him, wait for him, and just get this going. I'm hoping my collar thing doesn't hit the mic. Got this new jacket and shit. It's like a Manchester United jacket, so apparently I'm supporting Man U. Sorry if that's not a good thing or not. But come on, Jim, just accept the fucking challenge. God damn it. I am a little worried for his team because Volcarona, if that gets set up, it can sweep us completely. I checked some calcs with Malamar against Bisharp if I need to, with I still have a Chapelberry and everything, and even a +1 superpower will not guarantee a one shot. So I have that chance to be able to live hits from his Malamar, at least one hit guaranteed. And there's that, and I can knock off, if it's a Choice Scarf, knock that off so that Victini can come in here and Choice Band and U-turn out on it. I can Sucker Punch him twice, I can, you know, do all the other things I need to, and I can now guarantee I won't take one-shot it. So, we're gonna do this. Oh god, I'm a little hyped, just kind of wondering what the hell is going on. I am listening to more music again, I don't know why, I feel like I need to listen to music. Oh shit, here we go. Okay, so he brought four of the ones that I thought he was going to bring. He did bring fucking Meloetta and Rotom Fan. Why do you keep bringing Rotom Fan? I don't get it. But he brought the Mew, and it kind of looks like his Mew is either offensive, is either like especially offensive Nasty Plot with his team, maybe defensive Rotom Wash, and especially defensive Cofagrius, or it's the especially defensive Bulky Lead. So I'm going to stick with our guns and go with Little Dicky being our lead U-turn. That Tyrantrum is scary though. I'm betting it's either Choice Banded or Choice Scarfed, Head Smashing Tyrantrum. That thing is going to be a threat. We need to get Gastrodon and Cradily out here against that thing as soon as possible as we can. He did lead Mew. I guessed he was going to. And even if he has like Dark Pulse or Sucker Punch, I'm going to be able to live it because it's not Stab. And this U-turn, this is going to hurt. Watch this, guys. See, I bet he'll probably get Rocks up first. Oh, wow, that did nothing. Oh, shit. That literally did nothing. I thought it would hurt a lot more than that from a Choice Banded Uxie. Oh, he's... That... You sneaky bitch. He's trying my own tactics against me. Will-O-Wisping. Oh, God. I was not ready for Mew. I was not nearly as ready as I thought I would be from you. Well, I got that up at least. He doesn't have Levitate. I got Rocks up to be able to break any sashes he has. Who do I go out into, though, now against this thing? If I go into Bottle Opener, he'll either set up something else or U-turn and then burn me. If I go into either of these two, they get unnecessary burns. I could go back and obviously Little Dicky and keep going with against U-turns. I think I might just have to Earthquake, just to be able to get as much damage off on this Mew as possible. He sets up his own rocks, it's kind of, oh my god, that did absolutely nothing. Well, shit. What I think I'm gonna do, he has Reflect, Will-O-Wisp, Stealth Rock. I'm guessing his last move has to be a knockoff, or like a U-turn, or something. I don't think he would have a stab. I don't know if he would, or if he would go double screens. He has to have something that's offensive, so I'm going to go into Cradily here, be able to at least take more hits from him if he has something that's offensive. He can burn me, yeah, but Actually, no, cancel. I'm going to go into pumpkin spice better, because then the burn doesn't really matter, and you probably doesn't have toxic and will-o-wisp. Man, I really did think that you banded U-turn would do more. I really did. I'm like, oh, why? Fuck you, Mew. He hasn't brought this yet. The entire league yet. And he switched out to this thing. Oh, Lord. See, this was one of those things I didn't know exactly how to deal with. And I'm feeling it's gonna be like special. It's like it's always probably a mixed attacker because it can go Relic Song and then change forms to be more physical. I think I'm gonna go Scald with the hope of getting a burn because that's really the best thing I can do right now. He had Energy Ball. Oh shit! Well, hell, I got the burn at least. That helped. But he has Energy Ball, so I might as well go out to Cradilly because I can eat up any Energy Ball he has. He wants to throw at me. Well, I lost my Rindleberry right there, so... Hell, at least the Rindleberry worked. We had a reason to use it. So we're gonna go for another Energy Ball, yeah. That made sense to go for another one. I don't know if I really want to set up curses yet. Because if I do... If I set up curses with Cradilly now, it'll be a struggle for the rest of his team, because he'll have to bring out, like, Tyrantrum or even Cofagrigus to Toxic Stall me. I think I'll go for a seed. No, I need to set up at least one curse to do actually any normal damage. Switches out to Cofagrigus, I figured that much. So I'm gonna guess a Toxic's coming. I mean, if anything, I'm gonna guess a Toxic's coming. Like, there's no reason for him not to Toxic right now. But the only reason, I guess the only reason for him not to Toxic is the fact that Venusaur is here and Bisharp is here, like either one of them. If he Willows, then Bisharp is fucked. But I don't know why he would have Willow on both Mew and this thing. This thing, it seems more he went out to this to Toxic Stall me. Or not Toxic Stall, but you see what I mean. So I think the best play is to go out to Venusaur. Just because then I can just absorb the Toxic, get a free Leech Seed or stuff like that off. Sorry, Dad. I'll call you back in a minute. Okay, so he did Toxic. I thought he was going to. So now I can just Mega Evolve and then Leech Seed whatever he really wants to bring in. He might bring in Rotom Fan and just get a Leech Seed off on that. Doesn't have anything that would be immune to Leech Seed. So that'd be really nice. Get a Leech Seed off on Mew, too. That'd be great. Or hell, a Leech Seed off on this thing. He's going to Calm Mind set up. See, now he can't... He's not able to just stay in and set up now, so... Venusaur here being able to outspeed. Why is he not going Trick Room yet? He does still kind of have a Trick Room-like team. Should I go for Giga Drain or just power with Sludge Bomb? I'm thinking Giga Drain just to get whatever points back I can. Actually, I think maybe Sludge Bomb would be better. Get a Toxic off, maybe it'd be better. Or not Toxic, get some type of Poison if it worked. Nope. Oh, Jesus. That Shadow Ball actually did a lot more than I thought. Shit. I think a Giga Drain... The Shadow Ball is doing a good amount. But I think combined Giga Drain and the Leech Seed will be able to do enough to be able to counteract it. See what I mean? Kind of making sure my fucking webcam's not freezing. I don't know, I've heard a lot of people have been having trouble with the webcam is freezing. I don't know why. Or glitching out or stuff like that. So Giga Drain was able to do a lot more than I needed. And see, now he's forced. He got a little greedy there. And he's gonna die next turn if he stays in. If he switches out and comes back in, he's dead. So he might as well just sack it off. Well, now we have Venusaur at damn near full health. Who would he bring out, Rotom Fan or Mega Gyarados? He could bring out the Gyarados. I could see him bringing that out. I could see him bringing out Tyrantrum because he resists both stabs. I'm pretty sure Dragon resists both grass and poison. I'm like 90% sure because there's like so many resistances Dragon has, which is why I wanted fucking Tyrantrum in the beginning. Oh, he brought this thing out. So he's betting to be faster than me, which he probably is anyway. And probably betting to be faster and then knock out with a psychic move. So what I could do, honestly, I can probably even take a psychic move from this thing, possibly. But I could just go out to Bottle Opener and then absorb the psychic move and then Sucker Punch, or hell, if he doesn't want to stay in, Swords Dance up while he brings in something else to deal with it. I just feel like the psychic move is so obvious that he would bet that I would bring it. He would kind of play that I would bring in Bisharp. I feel like that's still my best play though, because either way, if he hits me with a grass knot, he doesn't get Aura Sphere, I'm like 90% sure. If he hits me with Relic Song, I can then still sucker punch next turn or bring in pumpkin spice and go, like, kind of go, yeah, I think bottle opener is my best play. I can't even convince myself that that's my best play, but there we go. The psychic move was so obvious, but I didn't see him really going for anything else. So I don't know if he will just, he has psychic and energy ball, so it looks like he's just a special attacker. I don't think he would have hidden power fighting on this thing, but I think I might just go for sucker punch just in case. Okay, he did switch out. I could have switched out, or not switched out, I could have just gone for the, you know, stuff on the Mew. And see, now there's no reason for him not to go for Will-O-Wisp on bottle opener now. And he's gonna outspeed me anyway, so I might as well just go into, let's go into Mew here. Because if he Will-O-Wisp, it's not gonna do anything. Yeah, it's not gonna do anything. And I can U-turn and get that, I believe it did, like, I'm gonna look up here. Yeah, I did 40% anyway, and that might be a max roll, but we can still get a banded U-turn. And see if it can at least kill. If it kills, that'd be great. If it doesn't, then we're in a little predicament again. But I don't think he would have any other offense moves, and if he switches out, then we can just get priority, what is it called? Initiative. Switch initiative. I always forget that term. I don't know why. But he's got to do something here, because he's either going to, one, lose his Mew, or he's going to just switch out into something and get a banded U-turn, or he might think I might V-create just to try to kill. It might go out to Gyarados to do that. Oh, he goes in Tyrantrum to do it. Okay. Okay, so now I have something. Mamoswine's not going to outspeed. They do want outspeed. The thing that will be best outspeeding is Little Dicky here. Especially if he is scarfed. I'm gonna go out to Pumpkin Spice, get a Scald off if I can, and get a burn. I don't know if I'll be able to live now. I always forget about Stealth Rocks. I might be able to live a Head Smash. No, probably not. Or a Dragon Claw. I might just be sacking off Pumpkin Spice here, which really, he's kind of not useless. He just doesn't have many other people he can hit. So I'm just gonna go for Scald and see what he does. I think he'll probably lock himself into something. Yeah, because it doesn't say any moves that he would have, like, leftovers. He didn't gain anything back. I'm gonna guess he's gonna lock himself into something, because it's really hard to run the Tyrantrum, unless you're the Dragon Dance set, to run anything other than Choice Scarf or Choice Band. Like, you're either gonna be slower and take a hit and hit back hard, or you're gonna try to speed creep things with Choice Scarf and be able to head smash Choice Scarf stuff. Because if you go the D-Dance route, you get both boosts in power and speed, yeah, but it's like you're more susceptible to getting burned easy and stuff like that. So I'm betting that's what he's kind of worrying about right now, is just that burn. I don't know. That U-turn still did a lot against this thing. It didn't resist either. Oh, he just went right for the Earthquake. Okay, so now I basically have to go into somebody. I think I have to go back into Victini and just V-create this thing. Now, V-Create won't do that much anyway, because it's going to be doubly resisted. If I go in Zen Headbutt, it's not going to be enough. He's going to outspeed if he's if he's max speed, he's outspeeding this thing. Fuck, Earthquake is going to be a problem. If I go into Venusaur, I can maybe take an Earthquake if he's not banded. And then hit back with, what, a Giga Drain? Shit. I think I have to go into Cradilla here. This Tyrantrum might kind of be it. It might be it for us. I think I'm just going to go, I might go for Recover just to be able to see how much damage he does and recover back up. Because if I just go for an attack, it's not going to help out too much. And if I go for a Curse, then he could probably two-shot me. So I think Grass Resist Ground, I think it's going to be a neutral hit. Like, it was neutral to Pumpkin Spice too. It still did a lot of fucking damage. And I have a lower defense stat. Oh god, this might have been a mistake. Except I don't know what else I could really do. He's not Life Orb either, so I'm guessing he's Choice Scarfed. I'm gonna guess he's Choice Scarfed just to try to outspeed Victini. This is starting to be a problem now. Like, this Tyrantrum is really a problem that I was not actually ready for a Tyrantrum that much at all. It was gonna be just kind of wearing it down as much as I could. I didn't really see. I kind of overlooked the whole Earthquake weakness. I was more hoping on having Pumpkin Spice have a higher HP to be able to take that Earthquake and then hit back with a Scald or something. Oh, he switched out. Oh, God. So he's trying to actually burn this thing then, or get another Reflect up. He knows this is a curse set, so he's trying to burn it and get a reflect up. What he might do, because the last turn I switched out, he might try to go for a reflect instead. And get more damage on little Dicky here. I think actually if I go to Venusaur and I take a burn, that won't be too bad. If I go to, I kind of want to keep Mamoswine around a little bit just to be able to pick things off. Like, I'm not going to pick this thing off even though I'm burned. So Mamoswine probably isn't the best thing to have right now. I don't want to put Victini in there against Rocks because he has like three more chances to get live Rocks. I'm going to go with Mega Venusaur because I don't really want to get burned, but it's like, oh, he defogs. Oh, okay. You sneaky bastard. Okay, so he has no offensive moves on this thing. All he can do is Will-O-Wisp me. And I think I might just go, honestly, for the Giga Drain. I might honestly just go for the Giga Drain. Because now the rocks are gone. I'm going for Giga Drain, because hell, if he would somehow want to keep this Mew around to defog again later, now I can know to try to predict that and bring in Bisharp for that defog. Man, if I would have brought Bisharp, I didn't know if he had another move, so I didn't want to get Bisharp burned, because I could see him burning the Cradily and kind of halting that curse set. Didn't want that to happen. That was one thing I did not want to happen. Seems like this has been like the closest match so far, but it's really that Tyrantrum. I've got to figure out a way to deal with that thing. Right now, without rocks up, I basically have to bring in Mamoswine again at some point just to get the rocks up again. I think like that reflect first turn and then going for back for that burn, I did not really expect. I honestly did not expect a burn coming from this thing, a Will-O-Wisp. I expected that more from the Rotom. What's he waiting for with this? He either lets his thing go down and loses his burner, which then lets kind of Bisharp deal with anything. Oh, he sets up the reflect again. Okay. So he basically had to set up reflect again to make sure that I can't just bring in Bisharp and sweep now. Okay, so this thing is a problem because even though it might be choice specs, I could see him doing that. Or trying to Will-O-Wisp or Toxic me or something. I feel like I still need to go for Sludge Bomb on this thing, just get as much damage. Oh god, he's definitely choice specs. If he's not choice specs, I don't know what else he is. Like, there's no other reason for him to do that much damage. Shit, do we let Venusaur go down now? Because Cradilia can still handle this Mega Gyarados. And Tyrantrum's the only one I don't know if he can exactly handle. I feel like if he quicks Air Slash again, Cradilia can probably take it because it's neutral. But then it would be like him locked into Air Slash and I could recover back or curse up. Yeah, that's what I'm going to go into. Because I could bring in Mega Venusaur here, like again, another Sack Off, and I could try to bring in Venusaur again later and then Giga Drain, stuff like that. So I'm still a little worried for that Gyarados, because if that Gyarados gets his Dragon Dances up, then it's going to be a problem, but I can probably live an Air Slash. Oh god, I can need an Air Slash up. I can honestly curse up here, because if he switches out, he's probably going to switch out into Tyrantrum. And if I have a curse up, I can live some more Earthquakes or Dragon Claws or Volt Switch. Oh, so he's not choiced. He's definitely not choiced then. It may be Expert Belt. I'm thinking more probably Expert Belt, because I did not think it would do that much damage to Venusaur. I'm going to curse up because this thing, Energy Ball and Psychic, and I'm specially defensive as it is, and he's burned. So I'm just going to recover and get as much health back as I can. Yeah, I'm going to be at full health with a curse up, and he's going to go down. So there's the Meluella gone. That thing was like a mental problem for me. I didn't know if he was going to be switching up with the typings, didn't know what he was going to do. He's going to be resistant to rocks, so the best thing I can do is Seed Bomb, or Curse, and then Seed Bomb. Or Curse, Recover one more time, and then Seed Bomb. Because I'm pretty sure I could still live an Earthquake from this range. Even if he locks himself into like a Dragon move. Why isn't he running Head Smash? That's what I'm not wondering. Because I would have done, I think Head Smash would have been better, because it's no recoil. It's like, 140 or something base damage? I don't know for sure. Somebody look that up and let me know, because I have no idea. But I'm just going to go for a curse now. I can pretty sure probably live at least the super effective Earthquake. Maybe not if he's banded, but it didn't seem like he was banded. Of course, I can't really tell because he killed Gastrodon from such a low range. But I'm betting he's choice of some kind, because if he switched out, But he switched out when I brought this thing in. Okay, there's the head smash. Oh my god, that actually did a lot. That really did a fucking lot. At least I still have leftovers, right? Okay. 63%. I don't know if I can live the next one. There's no one else I want to switch out to right now. I have to recover and hope that he gets a low roll or that I live the next one. Because that head smash is going to be a problem if Cray Cray dies. Because then I could bring in then obviously Mamoswine and either get rocks up, attempt to get rocks up, or Ice Shard and at least whittle him down so that Vatini can finish off. But still, I have to recover. Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Okay, so we're going back in Mamoswine. Get as much like health off of this Ice Shard as we can. It's because Mamoswine's basically not useless, it's just that there's nothing he can really touch anything anymore. Like, that was the problem with that burn early on. I was trying to keep him for later, for any, like, pickoffs we needed at the very late, but there's really no reason for it anymore with the Bisharp still hanging around. The thing he could be worried about, or he wouldn't be worried about against this thing, I guess, is the Earthquake, but he might be thinking on that on max, like, max speed Jolly and be able to outspeed with an Earthquake, which still will do a lot of damage. But his Head Smash will still knock me out, and if he's Choice Scarfed, he shouldn't be worried about speed at all. I don't know, guys. I just looked over at Skype because some other person just pinged or something. But let's see. Come on. Just make your move. I hate make your move, like think quickly, because I usually try to think quickly. But that sometimes, as you can see probably from this battle, has been my downfall. Oh, he missed the head smash. Oh my god, he missed it. And his reflect is worn off. So this is actually, oh god, he missed that head smash. That miss was critical. I don't care what anybody says, that miss was critical, because I can come into bottle opener and probably with a sucker punch actually knock him out. Actually, I'm going to go into Little Dicky. I know I can, I'm pretty sure even at 328 speed, I can still outspeed a Choice Scarf, thing like that. And I'm going to go, because really Little Dicky isn't going to do anything either to one either of these two except for Gold Strike later. I'm just going to go for Zen Headbutt, or I go for the more powerful V-Create. The problem with going for V-Create is that it's 4x resisted. That's the only thing I see the problem with that. And if I go for Bull Strike, it's resisted by Dragon. I don't think Rock resisted. Bug's resisted by both. And Zen Headbutt is only resisted by Dragon. I'm gonna go for Zen Headbutt. There we go. Oh. That Tyrantrum's gone. This is intense because me and Jim, I believe, are one or two of the only three people left that are undefeated. And so he's gonna definitely, I can see him going right for Mega Evolving Crunch. And he's gonna Mega Evolve right now. He's not Intimidate either, so he's Moxie. I think I might go into Bottle Opener and then, because if he goes for Crunch, then Victini's gone. I can't touch him with a Zen Headbutt, and I can at least come back in and knock him out with a Bold Strike. And if he sets up, then I can still go with Bottle Opener and Sucker Punch and get as much damage off as I can. So Bottle Opener really is the best pick here. Oh, he switched right back out. Fuck, okay, what's this thing gonna do to me? Burn me? Flying attack me? Like, nothing. Sucker Punch, bye. Oh god, he failed. He fucking did burn me. You dick. You flat out dick. I'm just gonna go for the Swords Dance anyway. Shadow Ball? That's weird. I'm gonna go for the Swords Dance anyway. I believe that gets my attack either at like, I think this cuts my attacks in half, so now Swords Dance has my attack back to normal, right? I wanna say that's what it is. I'm not certain, but I wanna say that's what it is. I don't know if that crit mattered. He was Expert Belt, but I don't know if that crit mattered. That might have. That crit honestly might have mattered. But I could see him either Mega Evolving and going for an Earthquake. I could see him Mega Evolving and D-Dancing and letting the burn bring me down so now he has plus one, or not Mega Evolving and D-Dancing, so that the burn brings me down. He's now I can't Sucker Punch, then I can't Sucker Punch, it won't do anything. And next turn he'll be able to get Moxie, and then the turn after that he'll Mega Evolve. I feel like Sucker Punch is almost my best play, but he could just D-Dance easily and avoid that, and I can Sucker Punch twice and it won't matter. Or he could just try to knock me right out. I think I honestly just have to go for maybe knockoff would be better. Well, knockoff won't do that much because he's a mega. I think I have to go right for the Iron Head. Okay, so he did go to Mega Evolve. Okay, Iron Head. I had to get as much damage as I could off, and he did D-Dance. So I had a feeling that he would D-Dance, predicting me to Sucker Punch. I feel he's just going to D-Dance one more time to be able to get the, what do you call it? To be able to... This Gyarados might actually win. To be able to, get that attack up while I die to burn. I have to go for the Iron Head again. Oh, he subs! What the fuck? Oh shit, okay. Venusaur, you gotta come in here and you gotta take an Earthquake. Like, there's nothing else I can do. I gotta get rid of the sub. If I get rid of the sub, then Victini can come in and hopefully outspeed after he's plus one. Because he's base 95 speed, I would guess. So, yeah, it might be a damn speed tie between him and Victini, but I gotta get this sub out of the way. So, Venusaur, I need you to do something. We put EVs in your HP. We put EVs, I believe, in your defense to be able to do this. You put EVs in your speed, hell, to be able to try to do it, but you're not gonna outspeed anyway, so that's not fucking mattering. I'm just wondering if he's gonna try to set up again and then lose his sub so that he can outspeed Victini. No, he just went right for the Earthquake. Fucking Christ. This might be it, guys. Because I don't think Victini is going to wave an Earthquake from this thing. Hell, even a Waterfall from this thing. I have to just go for Bolt Strike to knock it out his sub. Yeah. There's nothing else I can do at this moment. He's either going to... Yeah, so he's either going to outspeed or he's going to beat me here. Yep. Damn good game, though. That was a damn good game. GG to you, Jim. That sub, it was the sub that kind of was like, what the fuck? But damn, that was good. If you guys want to go see any other battles from the PIC, with Jim included, go and check out his channel. There'll be a link down below to both his channel and Twitter. If you want to see the team prep and see why I had what I had, there's that went up on Tuesday before this. And if you have any other, any other comments about the battle, then let them down below. If you liked it, leave that like. And I'm going to get up and out of here. That was actually a really intense battle. I'm not sad whatsoever from that, so... Anyway, you guys, thank you for coming out. I'm Carson from Toxic Gaming. And as always, you stay toxic. We'll see you guys. Fucking substitute, man.